Hi there, folks, and welcome back. Okay, so I put up a post last night in regards to this particular waistcoat, asking about extenders for this buckle type fastener rather than the popper type fastener. And I'll get to that momentarily. But what I got was a messenger load of messages, people sending me messages through Messenger asking me where I purchased this particular waistcoat from. What's the quality of it like? How much did it cost? And other people were asking me about this one, my denim one, and also this one, because obviously over the years of doing my videos on YouTube, people have seen I wear several different types of waistcoats. Now I've got a nice mixture of waistcoats, all different types of quality by different manufacturers. So this one is from Hunter Class. This is a company I really like. It's called Leatherec. They make really nice leather waistcoats, but also they make these denim ones with the leather finishing on them. So what we're going to do is we're going to go through these today, because obviously people have asked about prices, quality, where can they get them from, this type of thing. Because there are people, companies out there, and even sellers on eBay and stuff that tend to rip people off. I mean, if you go to Amazon to buy this particular waistcoat, you can be spending up to £60 for this particular waistcoat on Amazon. You can be spending 55 quid for this particular waistcoat on Amazon. This one here, I'm not sure if you can get these anymore, but they used to sell them on Amazon for their leather class. I did try to find it on Amazon, I couldn't find it. But to get this one, 75 quid, it's just ridiculous. Now, this one, I didn't actually get this on Amazon. I got this on eBay, right? And when I bought this one on eBay, I bought this one in 2011. It's just your standard, waistcoat cut, whatever you want to call it. It's got lace up down the side. I always like to have lace ups. This one is your traditional style with poppers. Yeah, and if memory serves me right, I think I paid about £35 for that one. Yeah. For this one, I paid about £35 for this one. Okay, you can still get these on eBay, but I can't find an actual main seller for Hunter Class on there anymore. The shop that used to sell these isn't there, but you can still get them. People still sell this particular one on eBay, but just bear in mind that when these came out, you could buy them for 35 quid. So if people are asking for an astronomical amount for it, they're taking the Mickey, okay? Because that's what they were. The leather is absolutely superb quality. It's lovely thick leather, and it's durability. And as I say, I've had this one since 2011. It's been through all types of weather with me. So long as you look after the leather, you protect it from the elements, this will last, okay? Absolute superb quality. I wore this rain, sleet, snow, blistering hot sunshine, everything, yeah. So this one is really served its purpose. Now this one, a lot of people want that Sons of Anarchy style, right? And a lot of sellers are selling stuff like this but in leather, right? And they're asking astronomical amounts of money. I mean, really stupid money. I mean, I've seen these copies of this in leather going for like 120 to 150 quid, and it just takes a mickey. But this one, I bought it in denim. Now, some people might think this looks a bit tacky when they look at the pictures on eBay for this, but actually in the flesh, it's not. And I think it's really good having this leather trim on the end because it saves the edges of the jacket, really, really strengthens the pockets. And I think it's just nice. And also this part here is around here, really strengthens them up. Yeah, and it's got that like Sons of Anarchy high collar on it. Okay, but they're in denim. Now I bought this one, and a lot of my videos, you'll see me wearing this when I'm doing my live streams, when I'm out, doing my videos outside and stuff. This is the waistcoat I'm wearing, yeah? I bought this one because I found this one was too hot on my back when I was out in Israel and also when I visit Malta and places like that, it was too hot. So I got this one, is a cooler one, yeah? To wear, because being denim, it's a lot cooler than wearing leather in blistering hot sunshine. But this, wow, I wear this over the top of my summer jacket, my winter jacket. And I bought this one in 2017, I bought this one. So I've had this one since 2017. It's made out of denim. This one gets worn a hell of a lot. And it has really stood up, really, really stood up to the elements. And also got the lace sides on it as well. So yeah, these denim ones, they are absolutely brilliant. I'll put a link for that in the description where you can get these from. I think I paid under £25 for this one on eBay. And as I say, it's got all this leather trim. It is real leather. It's not PVC garbage, you know, or anything. This is real, real leather. It's got, and also it's got really good, I'll show you this. I'm trying to do this one-handed. I really should have prepared for this, but there you go. You can see how good the poppers are as well. They're not shoddy poppers. Right, okay. So, and inside you got a zip pocket. And these inside pockets are really strong. I put my big wallet in that and, you know, inside these. And you've also got a pocket on this side as well. You know, so you've got just a slipping pocket and a zip pocket. Absolutely fantastic waistcoats. I tell you, I couldn't recommend them enough if you want a denim waistcoat. Now this one is a buckle finish fastener. Now what I'll do is, I found it difficult to find extenders for this jacket, but I did post on my Facebook, which has brought about this video because my Facebook Messenger got inundated. And it is a question I do get asked about waistcoats. Where do I get them? How much should I pay for them? Blah, blah, blah. Is this seller taking the mickey? This one here, I believe cost me £34 or thereabouts, £34, £35. I can't remember exactly off my head, £34, £35. It's also Leatherick company, the same one that make the denim one. And let's try and see if I can undo these without this is going to be a little bit of a nightmare to undo these buckles. I should have prepared this a lot better than I have, but I want to show you what you get inside this. Obviously, one thing that people ask about is pockets inside. This again has the typical Leatherick inside pocket, which is a zip up, and it also has your slip in pocket on this side. Yeah, all nice lining inside this, and the leather is really, really thick. I'm not joking, the leather is really, really thick. I can't talk about durability of this one yet because I haven't really put this one through the elements. These two, can't fault them, absolutely superb through the elements, everything. This one is going to be a different matter. I haven't had time to test it out yet, but judging by the thickness of the leather, this is really thick leather, and it's, you can feel the quality in the leather. It's thick. It's like thickness of this one. I don't think there's going to be a problem with durability with this one either. So as for these connections, there are several different ways you can get around this for the extenders, you know, and I'll put some links to some ways of different means of fastening these if you want to, you know, if you need to extend as such, because like you do summer and winter jackets, that type of stuff. Now this one I bought so it's really snug fitting, but I might have to have a summer jacket, you know, you never know. It's just one of those things. This is one that I can wear with just a, you know, a sweatshirt or mid long sleeve t-shirts when I'm out cruising when it's really hot. So this one I've got so it's snug, tighter fitting than these two. But obviously if I have to wear a summer jacket, I'm going to want extenders. But the reason I bought this, and people that ride a lot will understand, one thing that's a real pain is if you've got a lot of, you know, space between your body and your cut, if it's not tight to the body, they sort of whoo, they move around a lot, and I don't like that when I'm riding. I like my jackets to be snug. But yeah, and you get air in it as well, you know. So, but there you go. What I'll do is I'll put links for this, for the seller, for this. And as I say, I think this was less than 35 quid. I think it was about 34 quid. These are usually sort of like round about 20. These are usually about 25, 26, maybe 27 quid, depending on the seller. I'll put this link for the seller that I get these from. These are Leatherick as well. Can't recommend these enough. These are nice denim. They're much better for a summer cut. And of course, you know, you can extend them with the poppers, and you've got the ties down the side, so if you have to wear a jacket with it. But this is absolutely brilliant. I've had this, like I say, since 2017. Brilliant. This one, as I say, Hunter class, if you can find them. I didn't pay no more than 35 quid for that. So if you see them for sale on eBay and people are charging more for them for second hand, you know they're taking the mickey. Because brand new, this was 35 quid or thereabouts. And I can't praise this one enough. This has been through thick and thin with me. The pockets have held out inside and out. You've got an internal pocket in these. I can't sing the praises of these enough. These are fantastic jackets. And this one has been through thick and thin. And like I say, I got this one in 2011. So yeah, that's 12 years. Done very, very well. So those that have asked, this is what I get. You don't have to go through, you know, spend absolute atrocious amounts of money for a waistcoat. I'll put the links in description, but I'll also put some links in description for ideas for fasteners for this, for extending. Anyway, folks, hope that answers all the questions. You all stay safe, and I'll catch you another day, another way. And hopefully we'll be doing a live tomorrow night. So tune in for that too. Bye now.